In the twilight of their existence, stars like our sun embark on a cosmic feast, consuming the very celestial bodies that once danced around them in a harmonious solar system ballet. This celestial cannibalism has been a subject of fascination and study for astronomers, and now a groundbreaking discovery has brought a new dimension to our understanding of this process. Researchers utilizing the European Southern Observatory's Very Large Telescope, ESO's VLT, in Chile, have uncovered a physical remnant of such an event, a metallic scar etched upon the surface of a white dwarf star. This finding, detailed in the Astrophysical Journal Letters, marks the first time scientists have observed direct evidence of a star ingesting planetary material. White dwarfs are the dense, cooling remnants of stars that were once like our sun, but have exhausted their nuclear fuel. These stellar embers slowly fade away over billions of years, but not before possibly consuming any remaining planetary debris in their vicinity. This study, led by Stefano Bagnulo of Armagh Observatory and Planetarium in Northern Ireland, UK, reveals that the magnetic fields of these white dwarfs play a crucial role in the accretion process, dragging in and depositing material from destroyed planets or asteroids onto the white dwarf's surface, thereby creating a visible scar. The study of this subject, a white dwarf named WD0816-310, provides a compelling case study. This Earth-sized star, a remnant of a solar body slightly larger than our Sun, bears a concentrated deposit of metals on its surface. This deposit is believed to originate from a planetary fragment as substantial as or even larger than Vesta, the second largest asteroid in our solar system, measuring about 500 kilometers across. Jay Farihi, a professor at University College London and co-author of the study, emphasize the significance of tracing these metals back to such a large planetary body. The discovery was made possible by meticulously observing changes in the metal detection on the white dwarf surface as it rotated. This variation in metal strength, coupled with synchronous fluctuations in the star's magnetic field, suggests that the metals are not uniformly distributed, but are instead concentrated in a specific region, likely one of the star's magnetic poles. The implications of this finding are profound, suggesting that the star's magnetic field acts as a funnel, directing the flow of planetary material onto the star and creating the observed scar. This concentrated patch of planetary material held in place by the star's magnetic field challenges previous theories, which suggested that such material would be evenly dispersed over the white dwarf surface. John Landstreet, a professor at Western University, Canada, and co-author of the study, remarked on the uniqueness of this phenomenon, noting that nothing like it has been observed before. The study utilized FORS-2, a versatile instrument on the VLT, to detect the metal scar and establish its connection to the star's magnetic field. This was supported by archival data from the VLT's X-Shooter instrument, further confirming the findings. This research not only sheds light on the fate of planetary systems as their central stars age and die, but also provides valuable insights into the composition of exoplanets orbiting other stars. By understanding the dynamics of these systems, even in their final stages, astronomers can glean information about the bulk composition of planets beyond our own solar system. The process by which these metals are deposited on the white dwarf surface bears similarities to the formation of auroras on Earth and Jupiter, where charged particles are guided by the planet's magnetic field to the poles, creating spectacular light shows. In the case of WD0816-310, the material from a vaporized planet fragment was ionized and similarly guided to the star's magnetic poles by its magnetic field, leaving behind a permanent testament to its cosmic meal. This groundbreaking discovery not only highlights the dynamic and often violent nature of the end stages of planetary systems, but also underscores the role of stellar magnetic fields in shaping these final acts. As astronomers continue to peer into the cosmos, unraveling the mysteries of stars and their planetary companions, findings like these remind us of the ever-changing nature of the universe in the intricate dance between stars and their orbiting bodies. Through the lens of ESO's VLT and the dedication of astronomers worldwide, we continue to expand our understanding of the cosmos, one discovery at a time.